What is going on out there today, people of the internet, people of YouTube? I've just stopped in this playground right here. I'm going to film the intro to the stealth camp video. It is the summer solstice stealth camp vid. I always screw up these intros, so hopefully this one will go well. Check this out. Here we have the blue imp memory game. What the hell is the blue imp? Anyway, I have all of my camping stuff right over here. We have the 2021 Kona Shonky, absolutely awesome bike. Everybody with the Nemo equipment, Dragonfly bike pack, one person tent right there on the handlebar. That's a race face handlebar and a race face stem, just in case you were wondering. I have all of my camping equipment right here in this bag. This is a cheapo bag from Mountain Equipment Co-op. I actually got it on sale. It's a discontinued colorway. I got it for 34 bucks. 2 liters of water. I do have a soft shell inside. I was actually wearing the soft shell, but it's just way too muggy to be riding around here. It's raining a little bit. It's way too muggy to be riding around. And, you know, I'm sweating. It's terrible. Actually, it is really muggy. It's really humid out here. I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go back to the same camp spot I was in the previous stealth camp video. If you guys have not seen that video, I'm really not surprised. Please go back and watch that video. Maybe even give it a thumbs up. That'd be really cool. That video is going to kind of serve as an intro to this one, I guess. Now, I have to apologize right up front. This is not actually the summer solstice. The solstice actually hits tomorrow, but I think for all intents and purposes, hopefully nobody will fault me out there. Please don't fault me, okay? It's supposed to rain pretty well all night. Just like the last video, I have a little bit of a plan, but it's not a real concrete plan. We'll see how things go. Anything can change on a fly. All right, I'm gonna suit back up and get out of here. Well, I biked in here, absolutely no problem, didn't see anybody, but I got a problem here. As you can see here, this area has a lot of water in it right now. My campsite is down over here. I'm not sure I'm going to be able to get to it. Yeah, I don't know. You know, like I said, pretty much anything can change at any moment. I might be able to go in through the bushes here. We'll see. I left my bike back over here just to scout ahead a little bit. I think I can get through here, though. Well, I'm here now. I'm gonna do it. Well, I finally made it to the spot. What a difference a week makes. Right here is where the tent is gonna go up. I have the bike right here. I'm not really in a mad rush to set up camp here. I have plenty of daylight. I left a couple hours earlier. I'll tell you one thing. Nobody is coming in here tonight. I'm just gonna relax for a few minutes here before I do anything. First thing I'm gonna do is put some bug spray on because the bugs are out in full force out here. Oh, didn't expect it to come out that heavily. Now I'm gonna get this tent set up. I'm not gonna bore you with the setup. There is one thing I want to mention about the tent, and I'll mention it when I get to it. Just gonna get the footprint out here. I got a question on the last stealth camp whether or not I staked the footprint out. Originally I did, but then I just pulled the stakes up afterwards when I went to pitch the actual tent. So no, I didn't really stake it. I mean, I did, but I didn't. Does that make sense? Okay, everybody, I have the tent basically set up here. I just don't have the fly on it yet. This is the piece that I wanted to talk to everybody about right here. You can see it's kind of like this circular plastic clip kind of thing. And this ball end right here fits right in here. If this were ever to break, I think it would be very, very difficult to set the tent up. There's two attachment spots. There's one on the other side just like it. You could set the tent up, but it wouldn't be ideal. Something to keep an eye on, though. I don't know. I don't know about the long-term durability of something like this. We'll see. This is only the second time I've ever used this tent. Okay, I basically have the entire camp set up. I have my Therm-a-Rest in there. I have the sleeping bag ready to go. Everything set up. I brought 4 packs of, unfortunately, they are Mr. Noodles tonight. Not as good as Sapporo Ichiban, but you know what? Still pretty good. Like I said before in that previous video, there could be bears out here. I'm not really worried today. What I am actually worried about are these storm clouds that are forming over here to the north. Hopefully, it doesn't rain too very much because I don't want the water level here to be coming up to my tent. That would be very bad. This has got to be the stealthiest spot ever. This is an excellent camping spot right here. I've also got the Defiant headlamp right here, everybody. The $6 headlamp from Home Depot. I have a dedicated video on this. You can go check it out if you want. It's on the channel a few videos back. Probably cook up some noodles later. Get off the lens there, you mosquito. The bugs are out, but not nearly as bad as I thought they would be, which is always a good thing. Okay, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna leave the camp here and I'm just gonna take off and maybe explore on foot a little bit. There are some trails back behind me here that I wouldn't mind checking out. I'm not really too sure how to get to them. Or maybe I should just stay here. I really don't know. I did bring the GoPro as well. Hopefully I can get a night lapse shot. The last time I tried to get a night lapse, it didn't really work out very well at all. I don't know. We'll see if I even use it. Right now, I think we're gonna go for a walk. Before I head out on this walk here, I just wanted to show you guys here. There's the water right there. My tent is right there. The water does have to come up maybe a couple feet before it soaks my tent. Hopefully it doesn't rain that badly tonight, but I don't know. You never know. I basically had to carry my bike all the way through the bushes here on the bank. Well, I call it a bank. It's not really a bank. It's just a dry area. It's a good thing the Konashanki is only 27 pounds, which really for a dirt jump isn't spectacularly light. To put it in perspective, my cruiser bike is 37 pounds, so yeah, a nice 27 pound bike to go bike camping with is pretty much perfect. Anyone who wants to get to my campsite is gonna have to come through here. I don't see anybody doing that. This is the type of stuff here that they're going to have to climb over top of in order to get to my camp. Well, I'm gonna walk for a little ways here and I will see what I can see. I'm just wandering along this path right here. I really need to exercise good judgment here because I need to get back to the campsite and I really don't want to be doing that in the dark. I did bring the headlamp, so I mean, we're okay in that, I guess. It'll be very, very difficult to find the camp in the dark. I'm just gonna wander along here for a little ways. I think that this trail actually links up to a paved path. We're gonna find out. But yeah, here we go, everybody. Just down this green trail here. Hopefully no bears or Sasquatches jump out here. Like I said in the previous video, there has been a Sasquatch sighting out here in 2014. Maybe there'll be another one in 2021, who knows? See, you thought I was joking, didn't you? Wildlife, including bears, frequent this area. Be safe, be aware. This area was used by the Canadian Armed Forces like, I don't know, a million years ago, and apparently there are unexploded ordnance in the area. You can encounter these occasionally, I guess. I'll be on the lookout for them. Okay, I was correct. This does link up with the main paved pathway. Hang on here. There's nobody out here. I'm gonna walk a little farther down this trail here. Well, looks like we have some horse here. This is a horse trail. You can bring your horse if you happen to have one and ride it up and down this trail. I wonder how fast you're allowed to ride a horse on this trail, because I ride my bike pretty fast. I haven't seen a single person out here. I guess that's a good thing. Well, I've come to this water feature here, and I think I'm going to head back. The path actually does continue along this side of this river here. It kind of goes over here, but it loops back really quickly. I am just going to turn around and walk right back the way I came, which I think is this way. It's a really nice evening. Nobody's around. Go back, cook up some noodles, and then really, that's about it. Now, I'm relying on my keen sense of navigation here. I'm almost 100% sure I go this way, not that way. Yeah, you know what? I wonder how fast you're allowed to ride a horse on a pathway. I'm gonna look that up. It is actually starting to dim quite a bit, especially under these trees. So I've gone from 60 frames per second to 30 frames per second on the camera. And this is actually a really interesting area right here. There might be a nice little camping spot right in over here. Let's go check it out. I can hear people talking in the bushes over here. Okay, I'm going to leave them alone to whatever they're doing. I guess I can identify a pretty good camping spot. They're already camping over there. All right, I really want to get back to the campsite now. I don't know if the microphone is picking that up, but there's definitely some people right in over here. It was two guys on bikes. I thought it was other stealth campers. It's just two guys on bikes. That's awesome. just passed a dog walker, first person other than those two cyclists, or whatever you call them, mountain bikers that I saw earlier, first person I've seen tonight. The rain seems to come and go. It's very humid here. Walking around with all this rain gear on is really uncomfortable. I don't like it. Coming up to the point, I think, where I have to take a left. Okay, here we go. Left. Down into this valley, or the wetland, whatever it is. I guess it's not really a valley. The lowland. And then we just gotta go back to the campsite. And what we do now is we sneak off here. I think this water has risen since I left. Here we are, home sweet home. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna conduct an experiment. I'm gonna stick this stick right down into the ground here. Stick it in right there at the water's edge. And that way, I'll know if the water is actually rising or not. I think it is. I'm gonna go cook some noodles. I'm gonna check this in probably about an hour, depending on if and how much the water has actually come up. Might be pulling out of here. It's gonna be interesting pulling the bike back up out. Nah, it'll be all right. This is actually a really peaceful spot. Okay, well, here we go once again, making noodles on a stealth camp. Oh, here we go, here we go, here we go. Fill that up a little bit over top of the safe fill line. And I hope I have enough gas for another boil. We're gonna see here. Here we go. Oh, jeez. Singe some hair on my hands. Okay, we'll slap the lid on the jet boil and wait for it to boil. And you know what I just realized? I forgot a fork. Yep, I forgot a fork. Okay, well, I'm gonna have to use a stick, I guess. Unbelievable. I cannot believe I... Well, actually, you know what? I can. But you always forget something, right? Okay, we got a boil going on here. Holy crow, let's shut that off. Now, we use our improvised fork. We just let that sit for a little while. Oh, wonderful, I'm already getting bark in there. Let's put in the seasoning packs. This is my favorite part right here. All this salt, unbelievable. Stir that up a little bit there. Just gonna put the lid on there. Let those noodles kinda swell up a little bit, and then we'll have a feast. You know what? I'm actually gonna throw this long sleeve on because it's getting pretty cool out here. I suspect it's gonna cool off significantly tonight. And please allow me to be the first to say this. These Mr. Noodles are nowhere near as good as real Itchy Man. Still pretty good. They hit the spot. I thought about trying to bring something else out here to cook, but the problem is I just don't want to pay all the money for a freeze-dried meal or something like that. I was looking at Mountain Equipment Co-op. I was looking at, I don't know, some baked bean lasagna or something like that, and it was like $13. $13 friggin'. These Mr. Noodle packs are like 33 cents a piece. Probably not as good, but yeah, these noodles definitely hit the spot. They're much easier to eat when you have a fork. I just carry a plastic fork around with me. I wash it each time I use it. Last time I was camping out here, I broke one of the little, what do you call it? Like the, what do you call those things on the fork? The actual fork parts. Anyway, I broke one of those off and I threw it out. I forgot to replace it. Now, well, like I said, always forget something. The walk I just took realistically really wasn't that far. Maybe 3 kilometers at most. This area here is what they call a natural area, but it's really not very big at all. Big enough. Big enough nobody will find me tonight. Ha ha! Speaking of, I can hear the police helicopter coming this way right now. Yep, there he is right there. Well, he could see me on the infrared camera. I like to think he's not looking for me. Hopefully the police have something else to do tonight. They probably don't, though. The one piece of camping equipment I wholeheartedly recommend is the Jetboil cooking system. I don't know which particular model I have. I bought this thing years and years ago. I think it might even be the original. They got all kinds of different ones now. Just pick one and buy it. Just buy it. You know what? I'll put an Amazon affiliate link in the description. Please click through the Amazon affiliate links if you would like to support the channel. You're gonna shop on Amazon anyway. You might as well shop through my links. And if you've watched this video all the way to this point, you might as well just subscribe if you're not subscribed already. You might as well. Don't forget to like the video, leave a comment down below, share the video with everyone that you know, even people that you don't know, and turn on the notification bell. If you do just one of those things, it would be very, very helpful. I'm just happy you're watching this video to this point. I would like to explore the woods in the back here. I don't think there's any suitable sites for a tent, but a bivy sack, you could camp. Oh my goodness, there's all kinds of places back in here you could camp. Maybe I'll do that next, who knows. Over the summer here, I might even turn this into a weekly thing. For those of you wondering about welding content, I've got welding content. I'm not uploading it for sub 10k views. I'm sorry, you guys are gonna have to do something about that yourselves. If that's what you want to see, you're gonna have to start sharing the videos. I can only do so much. Tell you guys a quick story. There was a guy that used to come around the channel. He doesn't anymore, unless he comes around under a different channel name. I don't know. I was talking about following me on Facebook because I had a Facebook at the time, and he got all offended or whatever. He's like, why do you keep representing Facebook? Why do you keep plugging Facebook? You should be plugging Welder Web or something like that. And I'd never even heard of this Welder Web, so I went into my analytics to see where all of my views were coming from. Now, this is back when Facebook was actually kind of decent for directing traffic to videos. So I looked and I was getting, you know, I don't remember. It was a couple thousand views from Facebook. And I looked all through all of my analytics and I don't see a single view from WelderWeb. Apparently WelderWeb is where the real welders hang out. Apparently. Like, I don't know, Facebook was directing a lot more traffic to my channel than WelderWeb was. That's the thing, people who don't post videos, you don't really know what I can do with the analytics. I can find out all kinds of stuff. It's actually pretty amazing. Well, that was absolutely delicious. I'm glad I have another two packs, and I think I can get another boil out of this. I'm pretty confident I can anyway. Anyway, if I get hungry later, I got two more to cook up. I'm gonna have to put on more bug spray now. Well, I just went and checked on that stick there in the water. I didn't bother filming it. It doesn't look like the water's come up at all. I'll check it again in a little bit. I don't think the water's coming up. I don't know, though. Who knows? I've been sitting here for about half an hour with really not a whole lot to do. I've just been sitting here listening to the birds chirp. Yep, the summer solstice. Unbelievable. First day of summer. Longest day of the year. That'll, of course, be tomorrow. Everything after the solstice is down. Downhill. I mean, really, the solstice should be the midpoint of summer if you really think about it. But whatever. Not much makes sense. All in all, it's actually a really nice evening. I don't know how well it shows up on the film or the video, whatever, but there are some nasty looking clouds over there, and they are coming my way. So this could get interesting tonight. Who knows? You know what? It's always interesting. I always say that. It could get interesting. It's always interesting. I can't believe how much water there is here. I was here 1 week ago. I could walk around in here no problem. I wanted to go back to that big beaver dam, but I can't. I probably could, but I don't know. I'll tell you though, if the water does come up even another foot, I'm probably gonna be walking through water out of here. Yeah, in the morning, coming out of here is going to be very interesting. Didn't I just say things are always interesting? I'm pretty sure I just said that. Let me turn on the night shot here and maybe, ooh, look at that. The night shot actually illuminates things quite a bit. Here we go. Here is the Nemo equipment, Dragonfly bike pack, one person tent. I'm just going to cut right to the chase here, everybody. I recommend you pick up this tent if you're thinking about getting it. I don't think you'll regret your purchase. I really don't. Yeah, I really hope those clouds don't dump too much rain on me. Other than going to sleep, I really don't have anything to do. A little little while ago, I did go for a little bit of a walk into these woods here. There's not really too much to see, nothing really worth filming. There's a few possible campsites, but in all honesty, I don't think they beat this campsite right here. Next time I come out and do a stealth camp, I'm definitely gonna have to find a different spot to camp. I can't keep coming out here over and over and over again. Well, I suppose I could, but I gotta find other things to eat too. Man, this headlamp is bright. There we go, we're on red mode now. Okay, I'm gonna cook up the other noodles because I'm actually really hungry. Wind is starting to pick up a little bit. Okay, there appears to be an aircraft coming in here. Not sure if it is the cop helicopter or not. No, I think it's a plane. Yeah, that's an airplane. That almost looks like a fighter jet. That was weird. Let's get these ready to go. Also say this, these break up a lot easier than the itchy band do. That's not necessarily a good thing. Temperature is falling very quickly. I predict in the morning it is going to be a frosty ride home. It's going to be really cold in the morning. I hope I got enough gas for another boil here. All I can hear right now are frogs and some traffic coming from the west. Okay, well, I'm going to throw on the old soft shell here because it is starting to rain a little bit. And I mean more than it has been. It's been spitting rain the whole time I've been here. It's almost boiling. I am so hungry. I also got to say this about the jet boil. I am amazed how many boils you can do off of one can of fuel. Okay, we're good. We're good. We're good. We're good. Shut that off. Shut it off. Okay, there we go. Woo-hoo! More Mr. Noodles. This one's like shattered. Oh well. This big chunk of bark just fell off in my soup. This is going to be really good. I'm just going to put the lid on, let it sit for a little while. See? Now that right there, that is what I'm talking about. Absolutely delicious. Did I mention it's getting colder out? Because it is. Watch me be trapped in here tomorrow. Well, I can get out of here. Where there's a will, there's a way. Might end up just walking straight through the water. Who knows? I still like to set up the GoPro, but I'm not sure where or what I'm gonna shoot it at. Anyway, I'll check back in a bit. Okay, well, it's raining out. The water level has come up a little bit, but I'm gonna get in the sleeping bag here. I have an alarm set for 3:30 in the morning. We'll see how this goes. Okay, inside the tent, finally. Everything is organized in the landing zone. Well, it's organized as best as it can be, ready for tomorrow, which is really in a couple of hours. It's like 12:30 in the morning right now, so in 3 hours, I'm gonna pack this up and get out of here. It's kind of spitting rain now. It was raining pretty hard, but yeah, everything seems to be working out not too pretty bad. The other pretty cool thing about this light pocket up here at the top that has the headlamp in it right now, you can angle it right down, so if you're doing something at the head of the tent, you get all that light right there. I didn't set up the GoPro, unfortunately, so I don't know. I'm just gonna transition into the morning time, or, you know, in a couple of hours. See you then. Good night. Happy summer solstice, everybody. Morning, everybody. It's 5:15 in the morning right now. I decided to get a couple more hours of sleep. I actually slept pretty decently out here this time. See all the rain on the fly there. Oh my goodness. Okay, I need to start packing up here. Basically, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pack up everything that's inside the tent first, work my way out. Okay, here we go. The tent worked out perfectly in the rain. There was no leaks or anything. Oh man, I'm tired. I'm just gonna go check and see how high the water is. I hope it didn't raise up too much. The water is actually quite a bit higher. This one right here, this is the original stick that I put in there. And then I put another one in a little bit later. So yeah, the water's definitely come up at least a couple, 3 inches. Beautiful morning out though. Yeah, getting out of here is going to be fun. I'm only really looking at it from a perspective of keeping my feet dry, though. I don't care about keeping my feet dry. I can easily get out and just walk right through the water. Anyway, I'm not going to bore you guys with the striking of the camp. I've got probably, I don't know, 20 minutes, 30 minutes of work here. And then we get to push this bad boy back out through there. It's going to be, oh my goodness. All right, that's what we're going to do. Right there was my tent, and just like that, it's like I was never even here. I'm basically ready to go, got my bag right there, soft shells just hanging in the tree there, bike is ready to go, tent is on the handlebars, gotta go out here through the water. This is gonna be fun. Okay, here we go. Wish me luck. The water in here is way higher than it was yesterday. This is very difficult. This is really hard work. There's so much more water than there was yesterday. I just brought my bike in through this. I'm gonna scout ahead down here and see if there's any way I can get to the right. There's just no way I can get around there without going through the water. Oh, this is terrible. All right, I'm not really too sure what I'm gonna do here. Let's just keep going here, let's see. Okay, I don't see the pathway. I'm not gonna lie, I don't really know what I'm gonna do here. It's just pure hacking through the bush with a bike, and it really sucks. Well, I finally made it out. The bike right there. The path is just up over here. That took a lot of effort. I think I'm gonna close out the video right now. I hope everybody enjoyed it. It is summertime, officially. Officially summertime. I hope everybody out there is doing very, very well. Hold your head up high. Never look down the ground. I will catch all of you out there on the next video. You know it will be absolutely awesome. See ya!